Hi, I'm Lindy, and we're here today to talk about words. And I've always just loved vocabulary and vernacular and the lexicons that people use. And I remember as a young girl reading something about bad words. And I knew what bad words were. Those were those four-letter words we were never supposed to say. And this article actually said, those aren't bad words. Those are just factual words. We need a word to describe things. Bad words are words like hate or disrespect or intolerance. And I have no idea who wrote it or where I read it or why I read it, but I still remember it 40 years later. Probably more than that, if I want to admit my real age. And it just really stuck with me, the power of words. James in chapter 3 talks about the power of the tongue being like the rudder of a ship. It can determine where you go. And we all heard the term, a soft answer turns away wrath. Yet it's so much easier to respond harshly. But going back to words, I think some of the most powerful words in the English language, and I'm sure other languages have them, I am only conversant in English. I think a really, really powerful word in the English language is or. Two letters, it's all it takes, or. So when we woke up this morning, we had the choice of jumping out of bed or rolling over and pretending we were sick. And I hope you made a great decision. And we have options like that all day long. I can eat healthy or I can choose the chocolate. Y'all know I choose the chocolate. So I'm not saying I make the good decisions. I'm just saying or is a powerful word. We have these options every day. I can respond in love or I can let my mouth run wild and possibly hurt some feelings. And I know it's hard to always do the right thing, you know, save the money, use our time wisely, eat correctly, say the loving things, let other people in when we're driving, all those things that we know to do. Another word I think is incredibly powerful. And again, two letters, if. If I had, okay? That takes our power away. If I had studied harder in school, if I had accepted that job, but those are past and we don't want to dwell there, but we can use those to learn and make better decisions today and tomorrow and next week. So if I stay an extra hour today and work out better and get that report done, if I get a different job, go back to school, tell him, her that I love them. If I stop and hug somebody for no reason other than that they look like they need a hug today. Just think the power of two little letters, if. So I encourage you, look for those opportunities, stop ahead of time and think what your ors or your ifs might be, and live your life really, really well today. Have a great day. I'm Lindy.